everybody here? I think so. Very good. Well, welcome to First United Methodist Church. My name is Nikolai Peek, and I am the director of music here at the church. And thank you so much to Jeanette Oakley and the Northside Church, Old War Church, for coming and supporting this event this afternoon. You should all have a program, and let's go ahead and go to the back of the program here. And I'm going to ask you guys, if you can, I want everybody to be able to see the organ up close. So let's say, let's have the first three rows. If you could stand up, please, and come over here to the stairs, and I can show you, and we'll kind of do a round here. Okay. Alrighty. So you see in the program here that our original pipe organ was built in 1925 by the Henry Pilcher and Sons Organ Company, and they are based out of Louisville, Kentucky. And what's unique about our instrument versus their instrument is that their instrument had three manuals or three keyboards, whereas ours has only two. And you can take a wild guess at where the console was. It was in a very odd place. The original pipe organ's console was in that closet. So it was very challenging, of course, for the choir director and or music director to see whoever was directing. And then the facade or the pipes were all the way across the front, so that hasn't changed too much. And the main organ that we used to have, we had a lot of mechanical failures, of course, after a long time of using the instrument. And reminding Pastor Cindy, but it was back in 2013, 2014 that we had a roof collapse in the back of the sanctuary. So that promoted that we had to get the whole sanctuary renovated, which, of course, put the gears in place for a new pipe organ. So in 2015, a contract was signed by Michael Rathke and the church. And Rathke is an organ builder out of Cincinnati, Ohio. And I'm going to demonstrate it here real quick, but if everybody looks at the front of the organ and you see the beautiful wood, all of that wood right there was either from the Hoosier National Forest in southern Indiana and Michael Rathke's home farm in eastern Indiana. So I find it very interesting that the wood was used from that period. And if you look at the front of the organ here, what do you notice about the pedal towers? Anybody want to tell me what kind of shape do you possibly see in the middle of the towers? Any thoughts? No, okay. Well, it is supposed to be angel's wings extending up to heaven. So you can see that in the middle, you have the left side and then the right side. And of course, you can see that the cross is center because we should be giving glory to God in everything that we do. So you can see that that's how the design was. And you'll see also on the pedal towers that beautiful gold leaf trimming. And that is 23 karat gold that was carved and made in Gloucester, Massachusetts. And her name is Morgan Pike. And she was a carver, and she works for the Fisk Organ Company there in Massachusetts. And you can see too that the actual scale of the pipe or the length of the pipe is not equal to the tower. So that's why we put the carvings there, so it looks like it is full. And I want to come over here to the organ real quick. And if everybody could come up, please, if that's okay. Pastor Cindy, is there a light we could maybe turn on or get on? All right. Want everybody to be able to hear me? Okay. So I'm going to go first to the organ, and I'm going to demonstrate Anybody? Any thoughts? Okay. Yes.
It's a rank of pipe.
Correct. So yes, when you draw on a stop, it allows the air to go into the wind chest, and then it will sound on the pipe. But if you stop the sound, which means push it in back of that stop, then there is no wind to pipe. So I'm going to demonstrate this right now. Thank you very much, Pastor. Okay, can everybody? Very good. So you can see that we have a wonderful range of little rings. We have some flute stops, some trumpet stops, some oboe stops. So here is our wonderful commanding tuba on the first manual here. Two. usually on hymns and or sometimes big works. Here are two different ornaments that we have. The first is more of a Germanic type cornet, so it's very soft, very smooth. Then the other one is a mounted cornet, which is French, and has that, again, a very nasally sound to it. So here's the difference.
Thank you.
we can see that this instrument, this Baroque piece, is very, very, very well. So if you could all, let's see here, do you have hymnals in the pews? I will get you some. Let's see here. There should be underneath your seat if you have some. Yes, exactly. And of course, the ultimate goal was to serve Christ. And I love church work because being able to express the text is the most important thing in a hymn. So the organist's job each week is to use registrations that evoke each verse. And I'm going to read verse 1 for you. 139. Solo trumpet now. We don't have to sing, I'm going to use this on verse 2, and tell me, after you hear this, tell me what things I do differently to the melody to make it stand out more clearly, okay? So here's verse 2.
Thank you. Yes.
With a lot of top roots.
Yes.
And that man used his foot.
Yes, well, I would tell you.
Turn off my lights.
Yes, stops. Yes, well, this is really funny. I would never do this in a church service or recital, but our patron over in Evansville, Indiana, Robert Nichols, you might hear the name, you might know him at First President Evansville. He plays mechanical action instrument like this one. But here's the difference. He has no distance whatsoever. He has pulled everything by hand. So I'm going to demonstrate slowly but carefully. But he was playing and he forgot to do something, so he went like that. So I'll go ahead and do that. But anyway, so yes, thank you, Susan. But I'm going to wrap up now, but do you have any questions about this instrument or about the history of hymns or anything?